Hi there, and welcome to this video on Transactions ZipForm Edition. Today, we'll be going over how to create a template. Let's go ahead and get started. We'll start here on the Template tab. To begin creating a template, let's click on the New button. Our first step is to choose what type of transaction this template will be for. We can choose from New Listing, New Purchaser Offer, New Lease, or New Lease Listing. For our purposes today, let's go with New Purchaser Offer. Now that we've chosen the transaction type, we need to decide on a few other things. First, we need to enter in a name for this template. It's helpful to name it in reference to the type of transaction it will be applied to. Now we need to choose what category of transaction this will be for. These are the same categories you would choose from when creating a transaction. In this case, let's go with residential. Now that we've chosen a category, we need to decide when this template will apply. We have three options. Do not automatically apply this template to new transactions means that it will not automatically apply when creating a new transaction, but you can still manually apply it from a drop-down menu. Automatically apply this template to purchase residential new transactions means this template will only apply to new transactions that are both purchases and residential. Now, if I go up to the category menu and change this setting to industrial, you'll see this option changes to purchase industrial. The last option, automatically apply this template to all new transactions, means that this template will apply to all new transactions, regardless of type or category. For our purposes today, we're going to select the second option, automatically apply this template to purchase residential new transactions, in order to demonstrate how the system applies templates when the transaction meets the criteria of the template. The final setting we need to choose is the scope. There are three options to choose from. The default option is personal, meaning that the template will only be available in this specific account. Global and Office are only available to those with multi-user accounts. The global option gives access to everyone on the multi-user account to the template. The Office option gives access to a particular office on the multi-user account to the template. Both of these options allow brokerage administrators to determine level of compliance within templates. Multi-user accounts will be covered in greater detail in another video. We've chosen all the required settings now. Let's go ahead and click Save to create the template. Once the template is created, by default, the landing page is the document section of the template. In this video, we're going to focus on adding to three areas of the template: parties, documents, and checklists. One important thing to note before we continue is that when you apply these templates to your transactions, you will not be limited to only what you put into the template. You will still be able to add more parties, documents, and checklists to a transaction after applying the template. Let's start by going over to parties. The parties section in a template will look and function exactly the same as it would in a normal transaction. However, we need to consider that whatever information you add in here will be entered into every transaction the template is applied to. While you may not have contacts for the buyer and seller areas that will be the same every time, the service provider section contains contacts you may use on a regular basis, such as escrow officer, a home warranty company, or a pest control company. Here in the Documents tab, we're going to add some documents. Let's start by clicking on Add Doc, then Add Form. This will open up our forms library from which we can select what forms we need. In this case, we're going to add a buy-sell agreement, a counter offer, and a lead-based paint disclosure to our template, just as an example. You can also add documents like PDFs from your computer or cloud. Let's add a PDF from our computer by going to Add Doc, then Browse for Document. In this case, we've added a PDF document called a Home Inspection Report. Now that we have our documents, let's create some placeholders for them. Placeholders are great as a visual reminder of what documents have been completed or are outstanding. To create a placeholder, let's go to Add Doc, then Create Placeholder. Now for our PDF document, we can just type in the name. For the forms we put in, we can select Use Standard Name to get the exact name of the document. The reason for using Use Standard Name becomes important when using an e-signature option to send a document to be signed. While this is covered in greater detail in another video on e-signatures, know that using a standard name on a placeholder will allow that placeholder to be filled automatically when a signed form returns. Now that we have some documents in our template, let's organize them using folders. To create a folder, click on Add Folder, then enter the name into the folder. For our first folder, we're going to name it Working Documents. We're going to put all of our forms and PDFs into this folder. Next, we're going to make another folder, and we're going to name it Signed Documents. And we're going to put all of our placeholders into this folder. You can move items into folders either by two methods. You can click and drag them into the folder, or you can select each item, click on Move, and then choose the folder you want them to go into. In the Checklist tab, we can create checklists and tasks for our template. We're going to start by creating a checklist. Let's click on New Checklist and enter a name. We can edit our checklist by clicking on the little Edit Pencil icon to the right of the name of the category. We're going to rename this checklist to Meetings and change the color from green to blue. We can add additional categories to our checklist by clicking on New Category, then entering a name and choosing a color coding. In this case, we're going to go with Contractors and the color orange. Now that we have some categories set up, let's create some tasks. Tasks can be as simple or as complex as you need them to be. Let's create a very basic task to start with. Let's go into our meetings and click on Create a New Task. You'll notice that the only mandatory field in a task is the task name. Everything else is optional, even the due date. To demonstrate, let's make a simple Meeting with Accountant and change the due date to None. It's important to note that you can edit tasks after the fact, so creating tasks in a template with no due date is actually a very practical approach. You can create several tasks with no due date set and simply change them once applied to their transaction. Alternatively, you can create a relative due date for a checklist, which establishes the task's due date relative to a key transaction due date, such as a closing date, listing date, or date of contract, and automates the fixed date for the task once the template is applied to the transaction. Now that we've made a very basic task, let's try our hand at making a more complex one for our category Contractors by clicking on Create a New Task. We're going to make a more complex task this time. First, we'll call this one Roof Inspection Report. For the due date, we can either go with None, as we did before, Fixed, which is a specific calendar date, or Relative, which is a date chosen that is relative to another due date. We're going to go with Relative for demonstration purposes and select 5 days before the listing date. We can add a responsible party to the task, which can keep them informed when something is due. In this case, we'll select the buyer as the responsible party. We can also notify them when the task is due by switching this slider from No to Yes. We can also add documents to a task. The Select an Existing Document will attach a document already in the Documents section to the task. Browse for a New Document will select one from your computer. Create a Placeholder will create a placeholder in the documents attached to this task. In this case, because we're dealing with a roof inspection report, let's create a placeholder for the roof inspection report. Then click Save once we're done. There we have our checklist with two categories and some tasks ready to go. We now have a template with documents and a checklist ready to apply to a transaction. Let's go and create one now and have a look. Now that we're in transactions, let's create a new transaction by clicking on New. Now, if you recall, we set up the template to apply to residential purchase transactions. So for demonstration of the auto apply function, we're going to select New Purchaser Offer. We'll put in an address as per normal, but watch what happens when I select the category residential. You can see that a new pop-up saying templates automatically applied by the admin has appeared, and we can see our template has now been applied. Let's click Save and have a look at the transaction. We can see here the folders have been applied. If we go into Working Documents, we can see our forms in PDF. And if we go back and check out signed documents, we can see the rest of the placeholders. Let's go and check out the checklist. Here in Checklists, we can see the checklist and tasks have been created. We can even go in and edit the meeting with accountant to update the due date, as we'd previously created this task with no due date in the template. This view that you see the tasks in now is known as the checklist view, but there are other ways to view it. In the top left, there's a drop-down menu where you can also see tasks in a calendar view, where you can further view it in month, week, or day view, and board view, where you can move tasks based on their status. One last thing, you can also apply templates to existing transactions. There is a button labeled Apply Template, which can be found in the Transaction Summary tab and in the Documents tab. That sums up how to create a new template in Transaction ZipForm Edition. For more detailed information, we invite you to check out one of our webinars by clicking on the link in the description.